Tell me about it. What does it look like?
A stream.
A stream. Beautiful. Describe everything around the stream.
Forested area, like a glade.
Mm-hmm.
Hear the sound of the water.
Mm-hmm. What else do you see around this place?
A deer.
A deer. Very good. Mm-hmm. What's the deer doing?
Watching.
Mm-hmm.
From a distance.
He's watching you.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Can you describe what you look like there?
Mm.
What do you look like?
A boy.
Mm-hmm. I'm a boy. Look at your skin. Tell me a little bit about your skin.
White.
White. Mm-hmm. And how are you dressed?
Not sure.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at your feet first. Look down at your feet.
Some kind of sandals.
Mm-hmm. And just imagine that you have a spiritual mirror in front of you. And as you do, you can see your reflection. What does your reflection look like?
Young boy.
Mm-hmm. What color is your hair?
Brown.
Mm-hmm. Is it long or short?
Medium.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more about yourself.
Just enjoying the stream.
Mm-hmm.
Fishing.
Fishing. Very good. So let's see, what else do you have there? What are you fishing with?
A simple cord and a hook.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you're by yourself, or is there someone with you there?
By myself.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel?
Maybe 10.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's see what happens next. I'd like for you to close that scene, and let's see where it is that you live. Imagine it like as if it were a book closing and opening on another page. And look in front of you and tell me where you live.
It's a small cottage.
Mm-hmm. What color is this cottage?
Browns, natural wood.
Mm-hmm. Look around the cottage. Is there anything around it? Perhaps some animals or anything like that?
A dog.
A dog. Mm-hmm. Does the dog greet you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how do you get inside of this cottage?
Front door.
Mm-hmm. So let's open up the front door.
Mm-hmm.
And see, and go inside and tell me, what does the inside look like?
Rustic, like a farm or cabin,
mm-hmm.
older.
Mm-hmm. Describe what you see inside.
It's well tended,
mm-hmm.
Well kept, but it's small.
Mm-hmm.
Older furniture.
Mm-hmm. What is the furniture made of?
Wood.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you're by yourself, or is there someone with you in that cabin?
My mom.
Mom. Mm-hmm. Describe your mom for me. What does she look like?
She's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Blonde.
Mm-hmm.
Caring. Nice smile.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at her eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul, and see if you recognize her in the life of Walter today.
My aunt.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. So let's see what else we have in that house. Do you feel that there's anybody else there with you?
I think it's just me and her.
Okay, very good. Do you feel that you have a father?
think he's passed.
All right, so let's find out what happened to your father. Let's close that scene and open it again when your father is alive to find out a little bit about your family.
Much younger.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
A few years.
Mm-hmm. And what's happening in that scene?
I think he had an accident at work.
Mm-hmm. What kind of job does he do?
Cutting wood.
He cuts wood. So you'll know what happened. How did he die?
It was a tree.
Mm-hmm.
Cut it wrong and it fell wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And it hurt him.
How does that affect you? How do you feel?
It made me sad.
Mm-hmm.
But I was young.
Mm-hmm. Do you recognize your father in the life of Walter today?
No.
Okay, very good. So let's close that scene, and now let's progress to another scene in that same lifetime when something important is happening. See yourself there.
I'm apprenticing.
Mm-hmm.
Learning crafts.
What kind of crafts are you learning?
Woodworking.
Mm-hmm.
Furniture making.
How old do you feel there?
Maybe 18.
Mm-hmm. Look at your surroundings and tell me where you are.
A large shop.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of furniture all around. Different kinds.
Mm-hmm.
Tools.
Are you the only one there, or are there others with you?
I think there's somebody here with me.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out who that is. Allow that to come through.
The man who is training me.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this man?
He's very skilled, very smart.
Mm-hmm.
He's gone out of his way.
Mm-hmm.
To help me and my mom.
What does he do for you and your mom?
He's teaching me. But I think he likes her.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
It's fine.
Mm-hmm.
He makes her happy.
Very good. Very good. Is there anything else in this scene that's important? Look around you. Very good. So let's close that scene now, and let's move farther into another time when you're older now and something significant is happening.
I have my own family.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about this family.
Three kids.
Mm-hmm.
Wife. She's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Big house.
How do you feel about your success in what you do?
I've been successful.
Mm-hmm.
It's been hard work.
Mm-hmm.
But my family's taken care of.
Very good. Look at all of your family members and see if you recognize any of them in the life of Walter today.
One of my kids.
Mm-hmm. Which one is it?
The girl.
Mm-hmm. Who is she?
My sister.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel when you see her?
She's mischievous.
Uh-huh.
Like my sister.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Do you see anything else in this scene?
Everybody's happy.
Mm-hmm. How are you?
I feel the happiest.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's close that scene now. Let's move to where you're much older now. Something significant is happening. Where are you?
Still in the house.
Mm-hmm.
My wife has passed.
How old do you feel there?
Much older. Maybe 50s.
Mm-hmm. How did your wife pass?
Natural causes.
Mm-hmm. Are you still working?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Kids are moved on.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
I'm content.
Mm-hmm. It's a good life, isn't it?
It was a good life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So now let's move to the last day of your life in that lifetime. See yourself there and tell me where you are.
I'm in bed.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel?
Very old, maybe 80s.
Mm-hmm. What's happening with you?
Tired.
Mm-hmm. Look around the room. Is there anybody with you?
My kids are here.
Mm-hmm.
Some of my friends.
So take your last breath now. Feel yourself taking that last breath and transition out of that body. And as you do, I want you to think back at your life. Every life has a mission, has a purpose. What was the purpose of your lifetime?
The patience.
Mm-hmm.
To do a skill and do it well.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you did that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what lessons did you learn?
Patience has many forms.
Mm-hmm.
Many levels. It's not just about the work.
Mm-hmm.
Also the family.
The family is important too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So transition out of that body and away from it, and I'd like for you to tell me where you go after you leave that body. Take me on your journey. What happens next?
I feel like I'm going to a place where I see other energies.
Mm-hmm. Describe this place for me.
It's big, open. There's lots of energetic forms, mm-hmm. different colors.
Tell me more. What do you?
It's like an arrival point.
Arrival point. And take a look at yourself and tell me what you perceive yourself to look like there.
Like energy,
mm-hmm.
white and other colors.
Mm-hmm. So let's see.
Mostly white.
Mostly white, very good. So let's see if there's anybody there to greet you. What happens at this place?
My soul group is there.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
12.
Mm-hmm. I want you to connect with your soul group telepathically, mind to mind. So let's find out what you say to each other.
Well, happy to see each other.
Mm-hmm.
Be back. Some of them had harder experiences than I did.
Mm-hmm.
It's not often so many of us are here.
Mm-hmm. So how do you, what do you tell them about your experience? Or do you need to?
I don't really need to.
Mm-hmm.
We can share it freely here.
Okay. Very good. So let's see what happens next after you meet with them. Where do you go to now?
Some of them stay longer than others.
Mm-hmm. Do you meet with anyone? Any of your guides? Take a look.
There's a review.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what this review is all about.
It happens every time.
Mm-hmm. So let's go there and tell me where it is.
It's like I'm looking into a big reflective pool.
Mm-hmm.
And reflected back at me is the events of the lifetime, rapid
mm-hmm.
playback.
What scenes are you watching?
It seems like everything, but it's a certain emphasis on more important scenes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's done in a loving way.
Mm-hmm.
Never scornful or disciplinary.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes joking.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you do this? What were you thinking?
Mm-hmm. Who's around you as you're watching this?
One of my guides.
Mm-hmm.
Just one, I think.
Mm-hmm. So how do you feel as you're watching this review?
Mistakes mm-hmm. happen, but you learn from them. It's okay.
Mm-hmm. Does your guide tell you anything while you're watching this at all?
That's mainly what he's saying.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you learn from these events, and learn not to repeat them.
Mm-hmm. Very good. How long does this review take?
Subjective.
Mm-hmm.
Time's different.
Yes. Do you feel it's a short time or a long time?
To me, it was a relatively short time.
Mm-hmm.
But it may not have been.
Mm-hmm. What happens after the life review? Where do you go to next?
You can decide if you need to stay, but I'm usually good to move on,
mm-hmm.
to go back. Pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out how you decide to come into the lifetime of Walter. Do you meet with anyone to discuss it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Take me there.
You get to make choices, decide things, pick family.
Mm-hmm. What are you choosing?
Chose a good family. Loving.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out for what purpose you're choosing this family. What's the purpose of you coming into this next lifetime? Let's find out what you want to learn or apply or do. What's the mission?
It's not a complicated mission. It's not complex.
Mm-hmm.
It's more about patience.
Patience. Mm-hmm.
And lifetimes of direction toward positive, away from the negative.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you're close to that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
negative lifetimes are behind me. Mm-hmm. I feel I'm almost finished.
Mm-hmm. Is there any karma that you still need to clean up?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing major. Little mistakes.
Little mistakes. Little adjustments you need to make.
Little adjustments.
Mm-hmm.
Learning to forgive yourself is the most important thing.
Mm-hmm.
Forgiving others is almost easier than forgiving yourself.
Yes. Yes, it is. So let's find out if you gather together a team of those volunteers that will help you in this lifetime.
There are members of my soul group, my guides, that do help me.
Mm-hmm. Do they know what they're going to be doing in this next lifetime with you? The role that they'll play?
My next lifetime.
Mm-hmm. As Walter.
Oh, as Walter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This has been a pretty straightforward trip.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's see what happens next. What happens before you leave on this journey to become the person that you are as Walter? What's the last things you need to do?
I had to... wanted me to pick being a woman.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to convince them that I should be a man.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
One more time.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I just wanted it.
Mm-hmm.
I must have had something to learn.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what it is that you had to learn in being a man.
Relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Mistreating. In past lives I'd been men that were not good.
Mm-hmm.
It's time to be a good man.
Very good. Are there any guides that are going to come with you on the mission that you've chosen as Walter?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who are they?
Don't know the names.
Do they look like anything in particular? How do they appear to you?
To me, they look like soul forms.
Mm-hmm.
Energy.
How many are there?
Two.
Do you feel like they have male or female energy?
I feel maybe one of each.
Mm-hmm.
They look out for me.
Very good. Do they have any words of wisdom to tell you before you venture off into the baby of Walter?
They just honor my choices.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's leave that scene now. Allow yourself to drift away from that scene. I'd like for you to connect with your higher self. Do I have permission to speak with the higher self today?
Yes.
Thank you. I know you could have shown Walter many different lifetimes today. Why did you show him the one of the little boy?
It was a pleasant life.
Mm-hmm.
He's had many lifetimes that weren't pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's good to remember that not all the lifetimes are going to be dark.
Mm-hmm. Is there any purpose today to show him any lifetimes that he needs to work on today from the past?
He's more well-grounded than he thinks.
Mm-hmm.
There isn't a lot that we need to show him.
Okay. Because you could have shown him, for example, the one of Joan of Arc's life. Is that one that's in his consciousness?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It was a darker time.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that he needs to forgive himself from that lifetime? Is he holding on to anything from there?
Not really.
Mm-hmm.
His awareness.
Mm-hmm.
Is a kind of forgiveness.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that that soul has forgiven himself for that life?
Yes.
Okay, very good. So what was the reason why he learned about it when he did the reading with the tarot cards and then getting confirmation from his daughter?
It was a validation of his path.
Mm-hmm.
That he needs to trust his instincts.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to signs from his guides.
Mm-hmm.
But also his own instinct.
Yes. What kind of guides, guidance does he receive?
Gentle nudges in the
yes.
right direction. He's more on the right track than he realizes.
Mm-hmm. Well, the main reason he came here today was really to find out whether he should pursue a career path in QHHT. Can you tell him about that?
Yes, he should. He's on the right track.
Mm-hmm. What is the reason why he's on that track? What's he supposed to do with it?
By helping the people that he will help.
Mm-hmm.
He's helping his own karmic debt.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a way of balancing the past.
Mm-hmm. Which
as he perceives it, it's not really the past.
Mm-hmm. The past is happening now.
Yes, it's all simultaneous.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So as he helps other people, he's actually clearing up his karmic debt?
Yes. Mm-hmm. What's left of it?
Are any of these people that he'll be helping any of the souls that he's hurt in the past?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So he'll find them or they'll find him? In order to work this thing out?
Yes.
Does this happen a lot with practitioners?
I think you know that it does.
Uh-huh. So everything is intermingled. When you meet someone, it's not really by chance.
There's chance involved as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's not always intermingled.
Mm-hmm.
But it is more often than people think.
Yes. So we really have greater power than we really imagine by attracting these people. Back to us.
Yes, mm-hmm. because their debt, their debts are tied to your debts.
Mm-hmm.
And their strengths are tied to your strengths.
Yes. Is there anything right now that Walter is working on? Any of these karmic debts?
Little things.
Mm-hmm.
But he's achieved a lot.
Mm-hmm. If you were to look at the path ahead of him, how far on is he on his path? Like, how far along is he?
He's very close to the end.
Uh-huh. To getting to where he needs to be.
Yes.
Very good. So he wants some more information from you. That was the whole reason he came here. He wants more interaction with the higher self. Can you explain to him what's the best way to interact with you?
Trust
mm-hmm.
His instincts.
Mm-hmm.
and his hunches, because often it is our guidance.
Mm-hmm.
And his instincts are good.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't need to worry as much as he thinks.
No. Just let it flow?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Just a question that I have. Has he done hypnosis before?
Yes.
In what lifetime?
Early in this one.
Mm-hmm. Why did he not continue?
It wasn't his hypnosis.
Mm-hmm.
It was a form of it.
Okay.
He was it was an abduction.
An abduction.
Mm-hmm.
Was he abducted?
He was.
Mm-hmm.
As a young boy.
As a young boy. Would it be beneficial for him to see that, to help him clear that today?
He's more aware of it
mm-hmm.
already than he realizes.
Mm-hmm.
It was nothing harmful.
Mm-hmm.
And it was part of his contract.
Okay. Would you take him to that time now so that he can see what happened? I know he's very, very interested in this topic.
Yes.
All right. So take him there to the moment before he was abducted so that he knows what was happening at the time. What's going on? Tell me where you are.
He had been sleeping. It was at night
mm-hmm.
in his room. He felt a sensation like floating.
Mm-hmm.
And he was more awake
mm-hmm.
than he should have been. But he couldn't move. It scared him.
Mm-hmm. So he had like sleep paralysis?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What happened next?
He was taken.
Can you describe it for him, or can you have him see it? So we can heal that.
Yes, I can have him see it.
All right. So allow him to see that now. Mm. See yourself being taken.
Mm-hmm.
And let me know what you see around you.
He was not aware of what was around him.
Mm-hmm.
Energy, light.
Mm-hmm.
He was returned.
How long was he gone?
Maybe an hour.
Mm-hmm. What was done to him when he was taken?
Samples were taken.
Mm-hmm.
Genetic material.
Genetic material. Had this been done before?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How often?
Not to him, necessarily, but to his family.
To his family. So his whole family is part of this program?
Not his immediate family.
I see. His soul family?
No. No.
Can you explain that for Walter?
Not his parents or his sister.
Okay.
But his older family.
Okay.
It's been going on for some time.
Mm-hmm. What is the contract all about?
just that he was aware it was going to happen in this lifetime.
Mm-hmm. What was the purpose of giving them the samples?
They needed it. Their struggles. It wasn't done in any sort of negative mm-hmm. way.
Mm-hmm.
It was to help their species.
Mm-hmm. So it's like a scientific, like doctors type of thing?
Yes.
Just taking it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What did these beings look like? What species was it? What race?
Tall, gray humanoids.
Tall, gray humanoids?
Mm-hmm.
So did they look more human, or did they look more like grays?
They looked more like grays.
Okay. Was he afraid when this happened, or did he know what was happening?
There was a moment of fear
mm-hmm.
that he knew. He was more awake.
Mm-hmm. How has that impacted him throughout his life? This memory that he can't remember?
Generally, positively.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the topics it put him on as he grew up.
Yes.
The things that he became interested in later.
Mm-hmm. Well, right now he listens to radio shows that have this topic. Is this a way for him to try to remember what happened?
A way, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Will he be able to use now this experience to help others who may have gone through this before?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How will it help them?
He'll be able to relate to their situations
mm-hmm.
on almost a subconscious level.
Yes. Without judgment.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything left that we need to take care of from this abduction? Any forgiveness work or anything like that?
No.
Very good. Very good. Thank you for showing him that information. Is there anything else that you would like to show him today that would help him on his path? Glimpses of different lifetimes that may be affecting him today.
He's already seen them.
He has.
He's had intuitive glimpses.
Okay.
In some dreams.
Mm-hmm. Did he remember them?
Some of them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So subconsciously, he understands then?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Would you tell me what happened that one day when he felt like he was watching over his family? After he had passed. What was that?
Subjective future.
Ah. Mm-hmm.
It will happen.
It will happen. So he was seeing this probability of a future?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Did it mean anything to him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's aware of what it is.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to ask if he's had any other lives with his daughter.
Yes.
He has. How are they affecting their relationship?
Very positive.
Mm-hmm. What were they in that lifetime?
The roles were reversed.
Hmm.
She's always been a positive force.
Yes. What's the reason she's in his life now?
He needed it.
Mm-hmm.
And they've always been able to help each other, but she brings a lot of positive into his life.
Mm-hmm.
To help his direction.
Mm-hmm. And it's working.
Yes.
Very good. Why did she come so late in his life?
Factors he couldn't control
mm.
from earlier in the life.
Mm-hmm.
worked against it.
Okay. Did she choose to have the parent that she chose for a reason?
Yes.
Okay. So they're supposed to be together like this?
Yes.
Very good. Very good.
Right? They mm-hmm. continue to learn from each other.
Okay, good. He had a question about his finances. He tells me that his finances are just enough. They're never more than what he needs. Why is it that he can't seem to go past that bar?
He understands that spiritually, money is not supposed to be a factor. But he also lives in a reality where it is. So he struggles with that balance.
Yes.
The path of seeking money has been bred into the society in such a way it's almost a distraction. It's a way to control. And he recognizes that.
Is he fighting against it?
In a sense. But also there's a bit of laziness.
Ah. Is he kind of too content doing what he does and not pushing?
He tries to find a balance where he can have everything he wants. And it isn't always possible to have a perfect balance.
Where did this come from, this blockage? Because it certainly wasn't in his family. He didn't have struggles financially in his family.
It's not a blockage, necessarily. No. It's an awareness of an awareness of more the way the world should be than it is. He knows the world can be better, and there are a lot of controls, limiting factors to keep the masses under too much control. Spirit is not free to learn and grow and exist the way it should.
Is that changing at all? There seems to be a movement, a spiritual movement now.
Yes, it's changing much for the better.
What impact is causing this change? What's happening?
It's still a constant struggle, and there are still forces, very powerful forces at work. But slowly, the forces of good are prevailing, pushing the timeline into a better timeline than it otherwise would have been. Much has already been averted.
What kind of things have been averted? Where were we headed before?
War. Catastrophe. But much has been averted.
Is that because of the thought? People's thoughts?
It can be. It's possible. It's possible to want something enough to actually move yourself in a more positive direction on a timeline.
Has Walter changed his timeline in this life?
Yes. Before his daughter was born.
He made a shift.
He made a shift. He was very concerned about baby being healthy. And he wanted a healthy baby. And he focused a lot of his energy on it.
Mm-hmm.
And
what did that do?
How did that change the timeline?
For him, it helped create a little change that allowed her to be healthier than she otherwise would have been.
Mm-hmm.
Or was on the other timeline.
Yes. Does that timeline still exist?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do we ever get glimpses of those timelines? Perhaps in our dreams?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because there are some times where I, for example, will wake up from a, seems like a lucid dream where I feel like I'm a totally different person in that dream. Has that been because of a choice?
Because of a choice.
Mm-hmm.
It could be many things. It could be many things.
Mm-hmm.
But it is possible to move yourself into a more favorable timeline.
Mm-hmm. So for those people that are in the spiritual path, that want to live better lives, happier lives, with a better future, without these catastrophes and war, what would be the best way to do that?
It all comes from your own energy.
Mm-hmm.
The energy you project out into the world is the energy you'll receive from it.
Okay. Is that like the law of attraction?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
What the law of attraction says is that what you put out will come back, and it is true.
Mm-hmm. But why is it that sometimes you may be projecting that you want a better life, but it just keeps going downhill, keeps getting worse and worse?
Often those are outside factors beyond your control.
Okay. Will they adjust eventually as you continue to project positive thoughts?
Yes.
Okay, good. So in Walter's life now, what should he be focusing on? What kind of thoughts should he be projecting in order to be a successful practitioner in hypnosis?
He's already doing it.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the right path.
Okay. Very good. He wanted also to know about what's happening with his life right now. He's living with a family member and she's going to be moving on. What options does he have for living? He was almost attracted to the little tiny house idea.
Yes, that would be a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
He has support around him mm-hmm. for that.
Yes.
But there are many favorable directions.
Okay.
You need not worry.
Not worry. Who's guiding him now as far as these options are concerned?
He listens to the guidance of his family.
Mm-hmm.
He must also listen to the guidance of his guides.
Mm-hmm.
And he does.
And he does. Which is why he's here today.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He happened to get one of my canceled appointments.
Yes, he did.
So he was supposed to be here.
Yes.
Very good. Could you tell him how his health is? Would you do a scan of his body? And let's see how he's doing health-wise.
His health is good.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But he needs to be careful with his heart.
Okay. Can you tell him about that?
The history of it runs in his family.
Mm-hmm.
His father had issues. He needs to make sure he stays on top of it.
Can you tell him what he needs to do to have a good health for his heart?
The diet changes are a good
mm-hmm.
start.
Yes. He's gone to a Mediterranean diet now?
Yes.
With less meat?
Yes.
What would you like to see him do even further?
More exercising would be good.
Mm-hmm. Any particular kind, since it deals with the heart?
Cardiovascular, walking, running.
So something to make that muscle stronger.
Yes.
Okay. So if he runs, it's not going to hurt the heart. It's going to make it stronger.
Right.
Okay.
But his health is overall good.
Mm-hmm. He was concerned about having any influences. Does he have any hitchhikers that are influencing him?
He did, but he dealt with it.
Ah. How did he deal with it?
Actually, he learned that from you.
Mm.
He was doing the white light meditation.
Yes.
And visualizing the white light pushing out, removing any attachments.
Mm-hmm. So it helped for him.
Yes.
So it should help anybody else who wants to be able to do this on their own.
Absolutely.
Very good. Very good. Does he work with any angels or archangels also? Are there any that are influencing him?
He doesn't view them as angels or archangels.
Okay. How does he view them?
Simply guides farther along the path.
Mm-hmm.
And there are two that help him.
Okay. Are they present here today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do they have a message for him?
Believe in himself. He's done well. He'll do better. The financial issues will not be a problem in the future.
Mm-hmm. And if he moves into this tiny house? Even better?
Even better.
Mm-hmm. Is there any place that he needs to be living that would be more beneficial for him? Like areas of the country?
He'll travel later, but for now he needs to be here.
Okay. With his daughter?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And he would not leave her.
Okay. So much, much later when she's older?
Yes.
And doesn't need the constant support of her dad?
Yes.
Very good. Very good. What else do you have to tell him today? He didn't have too many questions for you.
He knows many of the answers already.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He wanted to meet you.
Mm. Which he has.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any message for anybody else that would be interested in getting information from a higher self?
They should seek you, or those you recommend.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Are we complete today?
Yes.
Very good. So I'd like to thank the higher self and all of his guides for all of the information that they've given Walter today. I know he's really going to appreciate it. Wide awake, feeling wonderful all over. Welcome back.
Yes. Wow.
Well, relax. How do you feel?
Good. Good. It's quite an experience.
So, what do you remember?
Pretty much all of it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How did it feel to connect with your higher self?
Well, good. Good.
Effortless?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And what about seeing these lives that you, the life that you saw as a young boy and growing up?
Mm-hmm.
Was it vivid for you?
It was good. Yeah, it was vivid.
How long do you feel that you were on this journey?
I don't know. It doesn't feel that long.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe an hour?
Yeah, it's about a little shorter than an hour. Yeah, you did well. You did fantastic.
Mm.
You got all your answers.
Yeah.
Plus some.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Yeah. So do you want to share this video? You want to keep it private? It's up to you.
I don't mind sharing.
It's very simple.
Yeah.
Nothing major in it. Mm. It's kind of just your experience and confirming what you already know.
Confirming. I feel like I was on a path.
Mm-hmm. What about your life between lives? That was pretty vivid.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You saw your life review?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. How did that feel? There didn't seem to be much emotion there. It was just, this is it. This is what happened.
Right. It seems like they keep it light. Mm-hmm. You know, it isn't like it's a...
punishing.
A punishing review, even mm-hmm. if you've done bad things or, you know, fallen off the path you were planning.
Uh-huh.
But, yeah.
All in all, it was good.
All in all, it was good.
Good. So let's detach you and let's say goodbye then.
We're okay. In San Francisco, and we just had a great session.
Oh, it was fabulous.
So tell everybody why you came here.
I came here not knowing what to expect, but I wanted to experience one of the sessions mm-hmm. with you.
Why? Tell everybody why you want to experience this, because this is really important.
Because I'm really wanting to go in that direction myself yes. and maybe become a practitioner of QHHT and help people myself.
Yes. Yeah, so. And it seemed to be very important that you do this. What we found out today is that sometimes the people that come to you are attached to you in some way. Yes. There's some sort of karmic debt there that we're kind of interacting with each other for a reason. So
yeah.
sometimes you feel drawn to somebody, whether it be me or any other practitioner, and it's because you have a connection with them.
Right.
And I think that was brought out today.
Yes, very much so.
So that was interesting.
Very much.
Yes. So what would you like to tell everybody about your experience and how it felt?
It was very relaxing,
mm-hmm.
very real. In the visualizations, you know, mm-hmm. when you're going through it.
How did you visualize it? Because a lot of people think they're seeing it on a movie screen. How did you see it?
It's very much like that. But I think that's probably because that's what we're used to,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
It was probably more like a 3D kind of
You're in it?
You're almost in it, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's easier to describe it as a movie screen.
Uh-huh. And did your conscious mind interrupt or interfere at all?
That's hard to say. I don't think so.
Okay, good. So you were really ready for this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you recommend this to others?
I would definitely recommend it to others.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Do you feel that this is going to make you a better practitioner?
I think it will make me a better practitioner, having mm-hmm. been able to see what this process entails. Mm-hmm. From this side of the process?
Yes.
So that's good.
Even though you are ready to do QHHT, but what we experienced today was I didn't use any of the induction for QHHT or anything. What we just experienced was the actual hypnosis.
Right.
So it's a good idea for you to experience all different types.
Yes, absolutely. I think so. And I'm going to be learning for some time to come.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Very good. And we have a t-shirt on right now.
Yes, my fade to black t-shirt.
Uh-huh. So would you like to say anything to our fader knots out there?
I just want to say hello to the fader knots and come to a session if it's something you're interested in.
Yeah, and I travel all over the place. There's a lot of interest here in California, but I do go all over the place. I'm based out of Miami, Florida. That's where I live. So if you want a session with me there, go to albaweinman.com. And you could also subscribe to my newsletter, and it will tell you where I'm going to next. So if there is a city near you, subscribe right away, because they get
booked up fast.
Booked up really fast. You are lucky.
I was lucky. You're booked a year out. I know it.
So thank you very much for watching. Until the next video. Bye.
Bye.
Good.